pets. Don't forget the pets.
And your pets.
It's going to feel like it's over 100, you're saying, Nellie.
Yes, wow. Our heat index, how it feels when you're out, is going to be over 100 degrees tomorrow. So it is going to be a tough go. And we've seen 96 so far. That has been 2 days. We've had high temperature at 96 this month. And it looks like we could be maybe a degree higher than that tomorrow. And that would set a new record. But 91, it was a late day high that we reached 91 today. 83 is an average for the end of June, and 96 the record, and that record back in 1933, and we did stay dry. So we're tacking on yet another 90 degree day. So today makes 7 days we've seen these temperatures, and we averaged 12 for the entire year. Last year, kind of putting things in perspective, we had 7. So we were already at our max from last year, and 39 is the most we've ever seen in a year. So 84 degrees out there right now. These temperatures are still plenty warm, and one thing you'll notice, we're not cooling off in the overnight hours when we see our daytime highs as warm as they are. 83 degrees in Pontiac. It is 79 in Mount Clemens, and in Ann Arbor, you're at 81 degrees. So we look at the temperature at 84 degrees. Feels more like 87 when you factor in dew points in the upper 60s, and our dew points anywhere from the upper 60s to low 70s right through the weekend. So we're just calling it dangerous heat. And this is pretty widespread too, not only through Michigan, but through the upper Midwest down to St. Louis. And we're talking about the deep south too. These are all heat advisories and excessive heat warnings that are issued for tomorrow. So for us here locally, that excessive heat warning has been issued from noon until midnight tomorrow. So it's all day long. We start to look at maybe some of the timing here. Anywhere after about 2 o'clock in the afternoon, upwards of 8 o'clock, that's when really the peak heating will begin. And we're going to see those max out at about 100, and anywhere from 102 to about 107 degrees. We're looking at the possibility for that heat index. As far as our future cast is concerned, we will stay dry as we go through the overnight hours, and mostly clear. Any chance for rain stays off to our north. And we're hoping maybe a front just comes through just sort of to break the heat and bring us some relief. We're certainly not going to see it tomorrow as we'll stay in that sunshine and hot temperatures. Sunday, we start to see some high clouds expanding. And then by Sunday, late in the day into Sunday night, and it looks like at this point could be pushing after sunset into Monday, we could see the chance for a few pop-up showers and storms with the cool front. And that does move through on Monday. So in the meantime, these temperatures, it's even a tough go at night, 75 for a low. And one of the things is that, yeah, the temperatures certainly are doable in the mid-70s, but with the higher humidity, it feels so muggy. 97 the high tomorrow. We'll watch if we do at least tie or set a new record. 94 on Sunday, and behind that cool front, temperatures still at or above 90 all the way through the week into the holidays. So just